Hello, my dear friends. Today I am going to discuss UGC NET Compressions and Application Part 5. In previous video, I have already discussed Part 1, Part 2, Part 3, Part 4, Part 5. If you want that video, you kindly go to my channel. The channel link is given here. If you want more videos, kindly subscribe and press the bell icon. Now I discuss the previous year's questions which will be coming in next UGC NET exams. 62 question: in a page memory, the page hit ratio is 0.40. The time required to access a page in secondary memory is equal to 129 seconds. The time required to access a page in memory is 59 seconds. The average time required to access a page is, according to formula, we know that average time equal to h into primary memory plus 1 minus h into secondary memory, where h is the hit ratio. We put the value primary memory. Primary memory means 15 nanoseconds and hit ratio mentioned as 0.4. So miss ratio is 0.60 and secondary memory is 120 nanoseconds. We put this value and we get the answer 78 nanoseconds. Next questions: in a multi-user operating system, 30 requests are made to use a particular resource per hour. On an average, the probability that no requests are made in 40 minutes when arrival pattern is possible is Poisson distribution is. From the formula, we know that in 1 hour, 30 requests are made. So 1 minute means 30 by 60 equal to half requests are made. In 40 minutes, request made 40 by 2 equal to 20. By Poisson probability distribution, no request made during 40 minutes, that is P of probability P, K event in interval equal to lambda to the power K, e to the power minus lambda by K factorial. Here K put the value of K equal to 0, then we get the value e to the power minus 20. Next questions: digital data received from sensor can fill up 0 to 32 buffers. Let the sample space be S equal to 0, 1, 2, 32, where sample J denote that Z of the buffer are full, and P of I equal to 1 by 561 into 32 minus 1, 33 minus 1. Let capital A denotes the event that the even number of buffers are full. Then P of A is, the answer should be, we can write as the series becomes, we put this value I equal to 0, I equal to 1, I equal to 2 in this formula. Get 32 minus 0 plus 32 minus 2, 32 minus 4. According to this formula, we get values 1 plus 3 plus 29 plus 31 plus 33. So the formula describes the sum of odd numbers equal to half into n into 2 into a plus n minus 1 into b, where n is the number of terms, is the first term, and b is the common difference. We put n equal to 32 by 2. This is the symbol of float divisions. And we get 17, A equal to 1, B equal to 2. We put this value 17 by 2 into 2 into 1 plus 17 minus 1 into 2 equal to 17 into 17 is 289. Recipe of A means 1 by 561, summation of I equal to 0, 33, 30 minus 1. I is even number, even numbers here. So we get value 289 by 561 equal to 051. Since it is even number, so for these reasons, we put I equal to 0, I equal to 2, I equal to 4. Now, next question: which of the relation on 0, 1, 2, 3 is an equivalence relation? We know that from RST, reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. From equivalent relations means here, when pair of values are common, so when pair of values are there, then that is the equivalent relation, that is 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. When the answer is that type of answer is coming, then it is called equivalent relations. Next questions: are these equivalent relations on 0, 1, 2? We find that equivalent relations from this series, the 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0. B option 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 0, 1, 1, 2. C option 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 0, 1, 1, 2, 1, 0, 2, 1. D option 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 2, 0, 1, 0, 2, 1, 0, 1, 2, 2, 0, 2, 1. E is 001122. Now, question number A. is equivalent relation or not, we describe it. Here R is not reflexive since 2 belongs to 2 does not belongs to R. So the definition, it is not equivalent relations. Now question number B. Here R is not symmetric since 1, 2 belongs to R, but 2, R does not belong to R. From this series, we can say that. From question number C, here R is not transitive since 0, 1, 2 belongs to R, but 0, 2 does not belong to R. So it is not equivalent relation. And D describes that here R is reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. So it is equivalent relation. This is the answer proper, is equivalent relations. And question number E. Here is a reflexive, symmetric, transitive, so it is also equivalent relations. If you like more videos, if you want more videos, kindly like and subscribe. Which of the following is an equivalent relation on the set of all functions from Z to Z? Here, f, g such that fx minus gx equal to 1 for all x belongs to Z, f, g, f0 equal to g0 or f1 equal to g1. F, g such that f0 equal to g1, f1 equal to g1. Since 1 is constant, so it is not reflexive. Since 1 is constant, so it is not reflexive, since it does not follow for all x belongs to Z, so it is not equivalent relations. F of 1 equal to f of 1, it is reflexive. B is the proper answer for equivalent relations. If f1 equal to g1 or f0 equal to g0, then g1 equal to f1 or g0 equal to f0, so R is symmetric but is not transitive. If f0 equal to g0, f1 equal to g1, it does not necessarily follow that f1 equal to h1. So proper answer is B. B is the our equivalent relations. C. It is option number C and D is not equivalent relations. Here D is the questions. Okay. D is the equivalent relation. Note A relation is called equivalent relation if it is reflexive, symmetric, transitive. Since Z tends to Z minus Z equal to Z for all K belongs to Z, so it is equivalent relations. Question number C. C option is not equivalent relations in this question. Question number 68. Perform the following operation for the binary equivalent. Decimal form minus 14 base 10 plus minus 15 base 10. So the solution is 8 bit representation is. First add two numbers, which is minus 29. Then its binary form is 1001101. Now we make the 2's complement of these numbers and we get the proper answers. 69 question, if the time is now 4 o'clock, what will be the time after 101 hours from now? We divide the numbers by 24 since 20, we know that one day contains 24 hours. So we divide the number 24 and get the remainders. So answer is 4 plus 5 is 9 o'clock. Next question. Let m equal to 313 base 4, n equal to 322 4. Find the base 4 expansion of m plus n. So we write 313 as base 4, that is 110111. 322 base 4 is 111010. We make the additions and we get the proper answers. Next question. Let capital A equal to this matrix and capital B equal to this matrix. Find the Boolean product. Boolean product, we know that 1 into 1 equal to 1, 1 dot 0 equal to 0, 0 dot 1 equal to 0, and 0 dot 0 equal to 0. If we multiply both tables, we get these answers. This is an easy question. Next question. How many distinguishable permutations of the letters in the word BANANA? Here A value and N value appears 2 times. A value appears 3 times, N value appears 2 times. So here A equal to 3, N equal to 2, B equal to 1. Total number is 3 plus 2 plus 1, 6. So answer becomes 6 factorial by 3 factorial, 2 factorial equal to 1 factorial equal to 60. Next question. Consider an array representation of an n element binary heap where the elements are stored from index 1 to index n of the array. For the elements stored at index I of the array I less than equal to n of the index of the pattern I. We from the binary tree, we know that left child L at 2i, right child R at 2i plus 1, from index I, parent will be at I by 2 flow functions. Next question. The following numbers are inserted into an empty binary search tree in the given order 10, 1, 3, 5, 15, 12, 16. What is the height of the binary search tree? After designing this tree, which is, we see that the height becomes 1, 2, 3. So height of the binary search tree, it is mentioned that in BST, that is binary search tree, contains the root elements, which is less than the root, it goes to the left side, which is equal to greater than, which is equal to greater than the root, it goes to the right side. In this way, we can design this tree and we get and we calculate the height of the tree, and which is answer is 3. Next question. The number of bits used for addressing gigabit internet is 48 bits. The IP address dash is used for host when they are booted. We know that when computer is booting, the IP address of the is 0000. Question number 77. Which speed up could be achieved according to Amdahl's law for infinite number of processes if 5% program is sequential and remaining part is ideal parallel? From the problem, we know that according to Amdahl's law, speed up for infinite number of sequences is equal to 1 by 1 minus p plus p by n per piece parallel program for n equal to infinity. Given sequential part of program is 5%, so parallel part of the program p equal to 1 minus sequential part minus 5% and 95%. Now s equal to, we put this value 1 by 1 minus 0.95 equal to 1 by 8 of 0.05 equal to 20. If you want more videos, then like and subscribe. Thank you for today.